Hi guys, welcome back to the vlog. I'm so excited for y'all for this video because I read 20 books in 2022 and I wanted to show y'all all of the ones that I've read and what I think of them. This is just my personal opinion. Obviously, you can take my advice or opinion with a grain of salt, it doesn't matter. I like more thriller books and, you know, a splash of like Colleen Hoover in there. Splash, LOL, but there's a lot of them in there. Start off, I'm gonna go in order and then give you my like top five books that I really like throughout the year. This book is How to Be Anti-Racist by Rom X Kendi. I really enjoyed this book. As someone who studied ethnic studies in college, I thought it was imperative to keep myself educated. I know this is a really good recommended book for people if you want to get into social justice, anti-racist type things and be on top of that. I did really enjoy this. Obviously, it's a more like educational book, but it's written really well and, you know, I've learned a thing or two about this community and how to be anti-racist, obviously. Next book is The Girl on the Train. My friend Ashley gave me this book as a Christmas present. It's not an inside joke, but for Christmas, this is the second year, Christmas, Hanukkah time, we give each other gifts, but on top of that, it has to be a book that we've never have read. So she talked about this book before she got it for me in 2021, and I really did enjoy this. It took a lot of crazy turns and I wasn't expecting it. I have not seen the movie yet. That's still on my list to do. But if you like, you know, thrillers about a murder that took place, I believe. I think that's what it was. It's been a long time, obviously, because this was the second book that I read at the beginning of the year. Commuter is on a train every morning and night and something happens and she doesn't know if it's her or not. So if you like that, I do recommend this one. I haven't obviously watched the movie, so. Third book that I read was A Familiar Sight. I read the second one as well, but that's later on. This is about a psychologist and criminologist who actually does have an antisocial personality disorder, and she helps killers or learn more about them in a way. So there's a high profile case that resembles something that happened to her when she was little that a lot of people blamed her for. So this is part one. I think the third one comes out this year, I believe, but I did get this. For some reason, it took me a while to figure out like what was in this book after I read it, but this is the book that I actually got my friend Ashley. I don't think she's read it yet. If you're watching this, you need to read it. You don't need to read the second one, but just read the book that I got you. A book that I've like obviously never heard about. And you know, I like to do the typical, you know, on-trend books as well as find stuff that I haven't read before or heard about. What I read was Reminders of Him by Colleen Hoover. This book like made me cry. It was, you know, seeing a girl who returns to her hometown after something happened when she was younger and everyone blamed her for it. She had went to jail for 5 years after the incident and wants to reconnect with her daughter. So I thought this was beautifully written. I know that a lot of people have mixed opinions about Colleen Hoover, but I've enjoyed all of her books. I know they're just easy to read and I've liked all the stories. This one was really good, really recommend. The next book is This Is How I Lied by Heather Gudenkauf. This is the cover of the book. This one was also really good. It had, I'm gonna say that about all of them because I really did enjoy reading all of the books, but 16-year-old was found dead in the caves in her hometown, and everyone tries to figure out what happened. No one really knows until decades later, and her friend Maggie is haunted by the death and reopens the case because she's a detective now. This one was page turning as well. It goes back and forth between some of the characters, which I like, instead of just like chapters. A lot of the books that I've read do that. I was shocked by the ending, to be honest, or more like towards the end. But another good thriller if you like all of that stuff. Where'd the Crawdads Sing? My aunt recommended this book and she said it was really good. I haven't seen the movie yet, but to be honest, the first part of the book was so slow to read. It felt like it was taking forever to get to something like juicy or interesting. I was shocked at the ending, and I just haven't watched the movie yet, so that's the next step for this one. I know that this is a Reese's Book Club. If you like that stuff, and if you've seen the movie and want to read the book, I highly recommend. The next one is, of course, Verity. This was probably my favorite Colleen Hoover book that I read this year, just because, like, I haven't read all of her thrillers, but this was the first thriller that I read by her, and it was so good. The ending, obviously, if you've read it, you know. Are you a manuscript or letter believer? Comment below which one you are, because I haven't read the extra chapter in her new book. I've been meaning to go into just Barnes & Noble and just read the chapter instead of buying a whole new book, but this was probably one of my favorite books of the year, maybe? I don't want to put anything on it, but possibly. The next one is The Silent Patient. This was also a really good book. It kind of mixes like real world with like Greek tragedy kind of stuff. I obviously really enjoyed this one as well. And obviously, if you've read it, you know that the ending is just crazy. You weren't expecting it, obviously. And you can hear Simba outside. 9 is Atomic Habits. Number 9 as in like the 9th one that I read this year. I sometimes go back and forth between like my thriller romance books and then like obviously educational stuff. So, and like mental health and, you know, getting your life together type shit. So this falls under that. This one was really quick to read. I use Audible so that I'm like reading it as well as like listening to it, because that helps me like stay on track with obviously getting through so many books. I would read this again just so that I could like pick up on more tips and tricks to do better on my habits, good and bad. But I did really like this one, and this is actually one that I will read again eventually, I just don't know when. November 9th by Colleen Hoover. This one was also one of my favorite Colleen Hoover books of the year, just because, I don't know, someone, I don't remember her name, we follow each other on Instagram, but she recommended that one to me, and I did really enjoy it. Just kind of like the back and forth, like character chapters is what I really enjoy, and you know, figuring out like how the two characters are connected. And next one is Local Woman Missing by Mary Kubica. This is the cover. This one was like half of them are like recommended and half of them I just like find on like Amazon. But this one, a girl goes missing and then also someone's daughter goes missing as well as the mom. And they just vanish blocks from each other, and the community tries to figure out what happened to her. Some people are trying to keep it hidden, but I was shocked by the ending of this one and like what happens, because like you wouldn't expect it. So would definitely recommend reading this one, one of my favorites. This is also another Alex Mikhail, I don't know how to pronounce his name, but he wrote The Silent Patient. This one's The Maidens. I also really enjoyed this book. I saw it on TikTok for like a second, as like after The Silent Patient. This is his second book that he's written, and I thought he did a really good job. It's very like, not like very similar to The Silent Patient, but it's in the same world because it like connects for like a brief second with what happens in The Silent Patient. So I was once again shocked at the like twists and turns that this book took me. So obviously recommend this one as well. Another Colleen Hoover book is Ugly Love. This one tries to be no strings attached like situation, because one of the main characters, Miles, has some traumatic baggage that comes with him, and they're just trying to figure out like how to be in each other's lives without it being complicated. But really enjoyed this one as well. I don't know, like it's obviously good, but you know, you can read the like cover on the back and figure it out for yourself. I saw this book at Barnes & Noble and I was like, is there a way to get it in paperback? But this one came out like recently. This one is The House Across the Lake by Riley Sager. My favorite book from last year was Home Before Dark, which she wrote, and that book like blew my mind. I was like, if that was a like, I have no words, because that was my favorite thriller book of 2021. But this one just came out recently. It's obviously new, but I did enjoy this one up until like the like last part where I was like, what? Like, I don't want to give anything away, but I just wasn't expecting like kind of supernatural stuff to come along with it. But to read some of her other books as well, but this one was definitely a good starter after Home Before Dark. But Home Before Dark is, that was my favorite one from the year before. Okay, next one is What Can't Be Seen. This is the part two to A Familiar Sight by Brianna Busquets. This just kind of goes on with the psychologist and criminologist who has the antisocial personality disorder and like works with the, I think it's Boston, yeah, Boston PD, and she tries to crack her own case that happened because she doesn't remember what happened that she was a part of. So if you wanted to read a second book by her, read the first one and then this one as well. The next one is The Wife Between Us by Greer Hendricks and Sarah Pekkanen. This one was a thick one to read, as you can see. I liked this book, but the like part one was really confusing because you think it's between like two different people, but they don't write the like name of who's speaking at the beginning. It just says like chapter one to like however many, but then at the end you're like, oh, that makes sense. Like that, okay. But this one took some twists and turns. Next one is The Familiar Dark. If you want something that's really short, this one is like, let's see, 233 pages. So if you wanted something short, this is great. A mom loses her daughter and she tries to figure out what happened. Thought this would be a quick read. It was, did really like it. And of course, It Starts With Us. This was a great ending to It Ends With Us. I know that I've seen a lot of like mixed opinions. I see where they're coming from, but I did really like this book and figuring out, I just thought the first one left you on a cliffhanger and you're like, well, what happened? Like what is going on? So, and the cover's pretty. Like, look at that. Second to last one is behind closed doors. A lot of people I've seen read this. A couple of my friends have read this and they said it was really good. It took me a while to get through just because like I was moving and didn't really like prioritize reading for a little bit. I didn't really like how the ending just like ended, you know? I think The Silent Patient did that. The Silent Patient and The Maidens did that as well. And I'm like, I don't, like, can you just like kind of end it better? But this one was about a woman who meets this man. He's an attorney and she has a disabled sister and they're newlyweds. Out that he isn't the man he said he was at the beginning. So it's just her trying to figure out what to do in this situation. My books towards the end of the year got a little more thriller and not as shiny. So the last book of 2022, and I actually finished it on New Year's Eve, is The Inmate. I got this for this year's Christmas Hanukkah present for my friend Ashley and I, and we both read it at the same time. We read it both in a week. This is like almost 400 pages, I believe. Yeah, 386. And Brooke is a new nurse practitioner at a men's security prison. She actually knows someone who is currently serving time there, and something traumatic happens to her in high school that like is related to the situation that she's in now. And there's like rules, and the last rule is never ever become too friendly with the inmates. So I did really like this one. I obviously, the twists and turns are there for a reason, so this was a good one to end on. And I'm currently working on another book, obviously, so I could do like a 6-month checkup in a few months over the books that I've read so far in 2023. Okay, here's my top 5 for the year. This is no particular order, and it was kind of hard picking out my top 5. Obviously, I did enjoy all the ones that I read more than others, but got The Silent Patient by Alex Mikhailidis. Oh, it's Greek and I can't pronounce it. Studied abroad, didn't fucking know. Verity by Colleen Hoover. Obvious for its reasons, took you on a fucking roller coaster. The next one is Local Woman Missing by Mary Kubica. So good. The Maidens, of course, because I really do enjoy his writing, and you never expect what's gonna happen, which is kind of the point. And then last but not least, I think I'm gonna do The Inmate because I was not expecting it and it was a good one. Just randomly found on like Amazon Prime on their like top chart for books. If you guys have any book recommendations for me, leave them in the comments below. I really appreciate it. As you know, I don't have like a set list of what I go off throughout the year. It's kind of like how I'm feeling. I'm in the middle of one, and then I have 3 more that I have in my closet that I haven't read yet that obviously I want to read this year. The one that I'm reading right now is not a thriller, it's a romance, but the other 3 are thrillers. So if you guys have any recommendations, I'd love to hear it. As well as, did you read any books that I had from this year, and what'd you think? Because I'd love to chat with y'all. Thank you guys so much for sticking to the end of this video. I do really appreciate it. Leave a like and comment below. Comment the like book stack emoji. You watched till the end. But anyways, thank you so much. I'll see you guys later. Bye.